Good morning everyone and welcome to today's market commentary. We are on Nifty daily time frame chart and today Nifty has opened above previous close and it is making new highs today. So one thing what we need to observe here clearly is the support taken by Nifty. This support line we drew on hourly time frame chart. And you can see that Nifty closed above that important support zone. Although it tried to make a new low here, by the end of the session, this gap zone acted as support on the first hand. And when it tried to close above the close of the opening of its prior day session. On 24th January, you can see that the price opened here and on 25th January, the price tried to close above the opening of prior day's candle. So what this suggests is up move is still possible in Nifty. So this we call it as price rejection from the support zone. So Nifty is not ready to make any bearish move as of now. That is what this candle suggests us. And as assumed, it opened gap up today and it is making new highs. On daily time frame, based on the pivot points, we have already marked our target, which is around 11,350. I'm just enabling the pivot points here. And this target was based on the Fibonacci trend extension. So for the people who are joining newly, for the today's market commentary, let me show you what is Fibonacci trend extension and how we got that target 11,350. So this is the price rally for us. Price once made a bullish rally, then a small retracement, and then again a new bullish rally started from there. So we'll choose our Fibonacci trend extension in which we have 3 points. Point A, from where earlier bullish rally started, and point B, where it stopped. Again, this is the point C, where the bearish rally stopped. That we call it as retracement. Now the 1.618 level, which is around 11,360, that is the price level which we have marked as our target for this bullish rally. And when price reaches here, we can expect a small amount of retracement from there. Until then, there are no signs of reversal in Nifty. So one more thing what we saw was the bearish divergence in Nifty. Earlier, when a new high was made at this point, if you see the corresponding RSI value, it was 79.77, and now it is moving up and up every day. So the value of RSI is also now 76.68. Just one more point is remaining. Around 3 more points are remaining. And once Nifty crosses that also, then this bearish divergence setup will also be invalid. But the important point that needs to be observed is when Nifty comes here at 1.618 and makes a reversal, then this bearish divergence will come into play. Until then, we cannot say that there is any reversal, any sort of reversal possible in Nifty. So on weekly and monthly time frame, the story again remains the same. We are just waiting for Nifty to reach around 11,350 and then we'll try for any bearish patterns. We'll search for any bearish patterns possible in Nifty. So then 3 things will be in our hand for confirmation. One is 1.618 Fibonacci trend extension. Next is RSI bearish divergence. And third, we'll wait for any bearish candle reversal pattern like bearish engulfing or shooting star or any evening star. Any bearish candle pattern will work there. So on weekly, monthly and daily time frame, we are just awaiting for Nifty to reach around 11,350. Now going to our hourly time frame. So on early time frame, these were the resistance levels which we marked in our earlier market commentary session. So today there is a breakout happening above that resistance level. So this was the earlier support we marked. So for some sessions it acted as resistance, and for the last 2 hours it acted as support. Today there was a gap up opening, and we can see that the first candle itself is breaking the prior resistance. Now, since Nifty is making new highs every day, now we need to determine what are all the points where Nifty can face slight resistance before 11,350. For that thing, we'll enable our pivot points. Pivot points are brought using the high, low and close of previous week's price movement. So what was the previous week? It was 22nd of January to 26th of January. So whatever the high, low and close made by Nifty in all these sessions, we'll take those and we'll combine it using a formula, and for us the output would be first of all the central pivot point, and above that are the resistance zones, below central pivot point are the support zones. This is purely based on mathematical formula. Now Nifty is trying to go towards R1. This is the first resistance that Nifty can face, which is 11,160. That is first thing which we need to observe. Next thing is price is making a new high here. If you see, this candle's high is the prior high made by Nifty, and after that there was no new high, and today's high is the next new high. If you connect the high earlier prior high with the new high made here and connect the responding respective highs of RSI, you can see a bearish divergence being made here. So what it tells you is whatever the up move is being made by Nifty, there is no strength in that up move. So once it reaches this R1, that is pivot point R1, there can be a slight retracement. Then next thing what we need to observe is until what point is it going to retrace. So for that thing, what we'll do is, this is the prior resistance zone. Going forward, we have seen in many cases, there's also theory that prior resistance will become support in future. Either it can become resistance or it can become support. Since there is also already a breakout, there is a higher probability that it can become support now. So this is the first level of support for Nifty, if at all there is a retracement. Now this bearish divergence will come into play only if there is a reversal pattern here, a candle reversal here. So whenever price is approaching a resistance zone, it is important for you to either spot out a divergence or spot out a bearish candle pattern. So one thing is clear, on early time frame Nifty is approaching R1 and it is also making a bearish divergence. Now for us the important thing would be to spot out any reversal candle pattern. If at all there is a reversal candle pattern, then it is sure that Nifty will retrace until this level. This is the support level for Nifty, 11,093 to 11,110. This is the first level of support. If there is a break of this zone, the next level of support for Nifty would be this. The support and resistance which we are seeing here is that zone where price stayed for more time. So this is a rectangular channel actually. So the highs and lows made, they are almost similar for all these sessions. So this rectangle zone will become support and resistance zone for us. The upper line would be resistance and lower line would be support. So that is the reason we have marked a horizontal line here. So at this zone there can be the second level of support, and thirdly this zone, the central pivot point, is the third level of support for Nifty today. These all things are valid only if there is a bearish candlestick pattern being formed here, and In case if it is not formed and if Nifty makes a new high in the next hour and if RSI breaks this previous high, then all this bearish setup will be invalid. So just wait for a reversal candle pattern here. And instead of that, if Nifty breaks here, then directly our target can be R2, which is 11,250. This will be the final target for today. And if someone wants to settle in between only, they can just take the average of R2 and R1. That can be somewhere here, the middle point of that. So the conclusion on early time frame is, it is approaching the R1 of this week. There is a first resistance of this week. Since we are on early time frame, the pivot point shown to us is valid for this complete week. So since today is 29th, these pivot points are valid until February 2nd. So this first resistance R1, this is valid for a week of time. So for 5 days, which is until February 2nd. Now, since price is approaching there and there is also bearish divergence being made on RSI, we are just waiting for a bearish candle setup here. If it doesn't make any bearish candlestick pattern and if it goes up, our first target is the average of R1 and R2 and second target is R2. If it takes a reversal, we know that prior resistance can act as support here and that zone is nothing but 11,110 to 11,093. If there is a break of that zone, this is the second level of support because price stalled there for many sessions. So that is the second level of support. And finally, third level of support could be the central pivot point of this week. So this is the story on early time frame. We have resistances being marked here and also supports being marked here. Next, let us move to 15 minute time frame. This is the intraday time frame. Even on intraday time frame, let us enable the pivot points even on intraday time frame. Now there is no bearish divergence on 15 minute time frame here. So that is the reason I'm removing it. Now on intraday time frame, which is 15 minute, price has already reached R2. So we can say that a sort of overbought zone that Nifty has entered into. And here we can search for any bearish candle setups. Now already we can see that some sort of reversal is being made here near R2. And if Nifty comes down, this is the prior resistance which can now act as support. The horizontal line signifies that. And there is also R1 for intraday. Now, how do we get these pivot points for intraday? Since we are on 15 minute time frame, the pivot points being displayed are valid only for a single day. So these S1, S2 and central pivot point R1, R2, all these are valid only for 29th January. And how do we get this? We take input as high, low and close of 25th January. And the output would be central pivot point for today. And there are resistances above that and supports below that. So this is how we get the pivot points. And price traded above R1 and it also reached R2. So this is a sort of overbought zone now based on pivot points. And we can now search for any reversal candlestick pattern here. If there is a retracement here, we know that prior resistance will act as support now. So there are chances that Nifty might come down to 11,110. And you can see that even pivot point R1 is also telling us the same thing. So this is in confluence. In technical analysis, if two or more things are telling you the same thing, we call it as a confluence zone. Or in plain English, we say it as a coincidence, but in technical analysis, we call it as a confluence zone. So prior natural resistance, here we call it as natural resistance, because we are not using any mathematical formulas here. We are just seeing where did the price took resistance for more for many times. So that zone we are telling as it might act as a support zone now. So this is the natural support zone, and this can this R1 will be the support zone based on pivot points. So natural support and indicator support both are in confluence. So this zone will have a higher significance. If Nifty takes a U-turn from here, this zone will act as strong support zone, and you can see, you might see a bounce back from this zone. And all this will happen only if there is a reversal in Nifty. That is, it comes down. Now, how are we sure if it will come down or not? Just mark a line. So let me remove the pivot points. The space would be clear here. So this is the first candle of today. You can see 29th January 9:15 candle. Here you will be seeing the timestamp. At this place you will be seeing the timestamp. So this is the first candle of 29th January 9:15. Just mark a horizontal line at its high, because this candle's closing price as well as high both are same, 11,135.3. So that is first thing of bullishness. That is the first sign of bullishness. Now, second candle also opened at the same price. So there is some sort of significance for that price level. Now just mark a horizontal line there. And if this red candle, if it closes below this, then we are sure that some sort of reversal can be seen in Nifty. And if that comes true, then again we can see that that fall might continue until this zone. What is the reason for fall might continue until this zone? Because earlier resistance will now act as support zone. In between this zone, there are no resistances or supports. This is just a single candle, and there are no supports in between these two lines. That is the reason I am saying that if Nifty closes below this line, we might see a fall until this line. And since there is a prior resistance here, a bounce back can be seen from this zone. That is the reason we have marked these two lines. So based on indicators and based on natural supports and resistances, we have marked our zones for Nifty. So it is trading at R2, and we are waiting for a close below 11,135. If there is a close below 11,135, and since there are no supports and resistances between these two lines, we hope that there might be a fall until this blue line. The reason for this blue line is because there was a prior resistance here. Now we hope that that zone might act as a support zone here, and even indicator is also confirming the same. We can see the R1, this line here. So this line is valid for today. That is also saying us the same thing. This is the setup for Nifty for intraday, and on hourly time frame also we saw that even daily, weekly and monthly, all these zones we have marked up. Now we are just waiting for a bearish setup here. If at all there is a break above that, we know that the first resistance that Nifty might face is 1160, and after that it is going to be 11,200. So this was the story of Nifty for today. Let's move to our other index, which is Bank Nifty. Our Bank Nifty is trading at a very important level. Since we are on daily time frame, these pivot points are valid for the whole month. So it started from January 1st, and this is valid until Feb 1st. Now, if you see this month, the rally started exactly from the central pivot point, and for about 3 days and 4 days, price took support near the central pivot point only. It is going up, took a breakout at R1 again at R2 it had to open gap up, and when it opened gap up it took support near R2 twice in this month. There was a good bullish movement and today it is facing resistance near R3. R3 is nothing but 27,643. And what is the high made today? 27,635. You can see just there is only around 8 points of difference between the high made today and R3. So this is the power of pivot points actually. If price is making new highs every day, be it a lifetime high or a new high, then how can you find out the immediate resistance that the price can face? Just simply enable the pivot points and choose the classic one. On daily time frame, you can see that these pivot points are displayed for around a month. So this is the live example that you can see here. 27,635 was the high made today and 27,643 is the pivot point, just about 8 points of difference between them. So on daily time frame, one thing is visible to us is Bank Nifty is at its resistance zone R3. Now amongst R1, R2 and R3, R3 is the overbought zone. That is what we consider it as, because amongst these three resistances, R3 has more significance. So whatever the movement it had to make for this month, it has already made. That is what these pivot points are telling us. There might be a breakout above this R3. That is also possible, but probability of its reversal is high here. And this story is valid only for this month, because on February 1st, we are going to get new pivot points. So this story will be invalid for that month. So in this month, whatever movement it had made, that it has already made, and now we can expect reversal at any time in this month. Since we have only 3 more days left in this month, what it can do is it can just stall itself for 3 more days and taking resistance near R3 only. And when the new month starts and new pivot point starts, we can see a breakout there. But for now, we know that R3 is going to act as a strong resistance. This is the story on daily time frame. Let's move down to lower time frame, which is hourly time frame. And in hourly time frame also, price opened above the central pivot point. This is the first 1 hour candle. And now R1 for this week also is nearly at the same zone. Let's mark a line even there also. $27,700. So this zone is a very important resistance zone for Bank Nifty. 27,643 to 27,700. A very important resistance zone for Bank Nifty, because on daily time frame, this line is the resistance. On hourly time frame, this line is the resistance. We are talking in terms of pivot points. And if Bank Nifty takes a reversal, we're not saying that it is definitely going to take a reversal, but let's mark down the lines. If it takes a reversal, this is the first level of support. Reason being, this line, if you see, for many sessions, it acted as resistance. So going forward, we expect this resistance to act as a support. So this is the first level of support. And if price breaks this zone also, so then this level is the next support. If you see here, price took support at this zone for many times. That is the reason I drew a horizontal line. And there is also central pivot point at the same zone. So again, we have a confluence here. So this is the strongest support zone for Bank Nifty, which is 27,276. This is the first level of support if there is a reversal from here. And this is the second level of support. resistances we already have. This is the first resistance and this is the second resistance. If there is a breakout from here, then again R2 will be our next resistance. The price level is 27,952. If this is your final target, average of this R1 and R2, which is nothing but the middle line here, that can be your intermediate target, which is 27,816 or 820 precisely if you can take. These are the resistances and supports for Bank Nifty on hourly time frame. Just keep in mind that this line here, 27,642 to 27,700, this is a very important resistance zone. If possible, you can search for any reversal patterns here, candle reversal patterns. So this is the story on hourly time frame. Now let's move down to intraday time frame, which is 15 minute. Now 15 minute, you can see this R1 is acting as a resistance for Bank Nifty. So this first of all, this green candle, it tried to close above R1 and immediately there was a price rejection. Although there was a high made above R1, it had to close below R1. Again, it tried to move up, came near R1, and again this red candle, you can see here, it is not allowing the price to go above R1. So in intraday time frame, we need to mark this line as our first resistance, which is 27,594. In intraday time frame, this is the first resistance. Again, this was the resistance which we marked on daily time frame, and this was the resistance which we marked on hourly time frame. So Bank Nifty is having many resistances today to cross upon. So it will not be an easy up move for Bank Nifty today. And if at all this red candle becomes active and if price comes down, we know that this earlier resistance zone, here it took resistance for the first time, for the second time, third time, fourth time here, and fifth time. So this resistance zone will definitely act as support in intraday. First level of support, again, this is the central pivot point for today. This is the second level of support. And this was the support which we marked on hourly time frame. So this would be the third level of support for Bank Nifty on intraday time frame. Here you can see, first time it took resistance here, then again it became support. Here it acted as support again, and it broke down and again it went up. Again it took a support here. So this will be the third level of support for Bank Nifty. Resistances on the upside and supports on the downside. So this is the story of Bank Nifty on 15 minute time frame. So Nifty and Bank Nifty, we marked our important levels. These were the indices for today. Now let's take one more stock, which is UPL. So UPL, this was the prior high made. From there, there was a downfall and this was the low made. Now in Fibonacci, we have a tool called Fibonacci retracement. So prior bullish rally we'll be considering, and when it made this bearish rally, we'll just connect the highest high point and the lowest low point. From there, we got these zones, 0.236, 0.382 and all these zones. When it moved up, you can see here, this bullish rally at 0.618, there was a price rejection and there was a big red candle. It fell until 0.382. And again, from 0.382, again, there is a price rejection now. There is a gap up opening and you can see that price is moving up. One thing is, this is a rising channel. And how did we get this? Just connect the low of all the candles visible, and this trending line is acting as a support now. So this red candle, it found support near this trend line. We call it as a trend line. We connect the highs of candle and we connect the lows of this candle. So this high acted as a resistance, so there was a price rejection from the upside. And again this low, the line connecting all the lows, that acted as a strong support. That is the reason we could see a price reversal from there. Now if I zoom out a little bit, there is also a trend line resistance from the top. If I connect the high of this candle and again high of this candle, and if I extend that straight line, so this zone is a very, very important zone for UPL. If there is a close above 795 in UPL, we can see price going until 820 again. Let's note down these price levels. Now the reason why we are suggesting this price level is because priorly we had a support here, this candle and this candle. Going forward, that acted as a resistance. Now again, there is a chance that this horizontal line can act as a resistance. That is our first reason for recommending this 795 price level. Secondly, this is also 0.5 retrace, 50% of retracement in Fibonacci. So trend line resistance, prior support becoming resistance now, and 0.5 retracement. These three things are telling us if UPL manages to close above 795, then we are bullish on UPL, and for us the target would be 820. And if at all there is a reversal from here, we can see that price might come again to 768 levels. So these are the two important price levels in UPL. Let's enable our pivot points also and see what they are telling. So even pivot point is also telling us the same. The R1 is exactly at 795. So this 795 in any term is going to be a very important resistance zone for UPL. So let the price close above that, or let the price take a reversal from that for a bullish setup or bearish setup. If price closes above 795, then try to take a bullish position. And if price takes a reversal from there, and if you are able to find out any bearish candle setup there, then you can take a bearish setup, and your target for that could be 768. For bullish, it is 820, and for bearish, it is 768. So this is the story of UPL for today. So we have discussed about Nifty, Bank Nifty, and UPL. This is all for today's market commentary. Thank you all for joining.